Okay, so today we're going to be continuing with our Flying Ace pie game. Currently, we should have something kind of like this. If we run it, let's see where we're at. Oh, gotta run the Flying Ace here. There we go. And we can control the plane, and if we crash into the plane, we have this kind of broken up look and we fall off the screen. A couple things we need to add or fix. A while ago, I turned off sound. Let me make sure you have that on. So, in the sounds folder, you should have. Let's see here. We should have. I got Flying Ace Lesson 5. So we have we should have a sounds, and mine's called Sounds. Engine hum, which is fine. Whatever you have it named here in your sounds folder, just have that there. And we have this loaded in our playing class, and we just want to go ahead and start it. So I'm going to say engine sounds dot play, and I want it to loop forever. So I use the optional parameter loops or optional argument, same thing, and I set it to -1. If you set it to like loops equals 5, it'll loop 5 times and stop. Now, if we die, which is in our update here, we have if we're alive, we do one thing, else we do another. I want to go ahead and kill the engine. And originally self dot in sound, let's see what it was called, self dot engine sound, and we just say dot stop. Now originally I thought I would have the engine sound go away when you fell off the screen, but I kind of like this. It's kind of an unnerving feeling to have it stop there, and then as soon as you hit it's gone. So and I don't know if you can hear the sound through the camera since it's in my headphones, but that's I'll let you play around with that. It's kind of neat. So anyway, I just want to go ahead and get that sounds thing taken care of. But otherwise, our goal today is to add a point system, and it'll not be the only way we make points though. And we're going to add another enemy so we can look at how we can do that. So first of all, let's go to the enemy class and let's take a look at one way we can make points. Well, I think every time an enemy flies across the screen and has to be reset, we should get some points. So we need to make some kind of changes to this to be able to do that. So we can go back to Flying Ace, and you can notice that we have in our Flying Ace application, we have a plane called self.plane. But I want that plane to be able to get points to it. So we'll go to the plane class and we'll take a look at our members here that we set in the init. Let's go ahead and make some points, which will start at 0. Now, in the enemy class, what I want to be able to do is I want to be able to change those planes' scores. So what I'm going to do with my enemy is I'm going to add a variable, and I can either add a reference to the game or to the plane itself. I'm just going to give myself a reference to the player. So I'll take in player and we'll set self.player equal to player. So now I've got a reference to the player. And so when I update the enemy's position to the other side of the screen, I'm going to say self.player.points plus equals 1. But I need to go in order to do that. So I added player here to the init so that I get a reference to it here so that I can add points every time I update. But now that's going to cause a problem every time I try and make a plane. I need to send self.player. Okay, and let's make sure that we have a self.player at that point. Actually, it's self.plane right there. So we're going to send self.plane. There we go. Now we have a reference to our score. All right, so the next thing we need to do is we need to be able to put that score on the screen. And putting text on the screen is actually kind of complicated in Pygame, but this is, I think, the easiest way to do it. So I'm going to go to my Format class, and I'm just going to add a font variable, which is going to be under Pygame.font, and we'll use System font. And I'll say Times New Roman, size 30, bold equals true, and italic will leave false. Okay, so I've got just this font created, and I need a font object to be able to write to the screen. So now in our game loop, where do we want to put this? I'll tell you what, let's just go to, I think, right here. We'll do it right here. So after we draw the sprites, that way it'll be on top of them. In order to make a text, you have to make a text surface. So I'm going to call this points or point surface. And it's in format.font. That was the name of my object, right? I put it in the format class dot font, and the variable is called dot render. So I'll be stringing the points from the self.plane. And true, this is for making the, it's a graphic enhancer. It makes the edges of the text look good. And we'll be doing color dot black. All right, so that looks pretty good. And that should pretty much make the surface. We just need to add it to the screen. So I'll say self.screen dot blit. Blit is when you copy one surface onto another. And I'll be copying point surface onto the screen. And I need to tell it where. So I'm going to be putting my points. Let's put it at the far edge, minus 20 pixels or 100 pixels. And then we'll do it 20 pixels down from the top. So it'll be kind of over here on the right. All right, so now we should have some points on our screen. Let's take a look. Oh, I did not initialize font, so I need to do that. So I'll just, you have to initialize pg dot font dot init. I'll just put that there. All right, trying again. All right, so now we have some points, and as the planes fly past, we get some more points. All right, but right now our game is pretty easy. And so what I want to do is make it to where we get some new planes that appear after, say, 5 points. So let's take a look at how we can do that. We're going to go to our enemy module, and we're going to make a new enemy. So I'm going to make another class here. And I could conceivably subclass enemy, but I'll just go ahead and make this its own standalone class. Faster enemy is what we'll call this. And it'll take an X, Y, and the player plane. Or let's just call it player. Oh, you know what? I'm putting this in the wrong place. There we go. Just that. And faster enemy will subclass Pygame.sprite. And there's our initializer, self. This is where we'll take in the X, the Y, and the player plane. And super, we need to make sure that we call the initializer of the sprite class. We need to set an image, and I've got a nice little image here. And I'll show that in just a second. So I'm just going to be joining my image folder from the. Well, I'll do this in two steps, actually. Call that image file. So we'll join our image folder with what is called, this is going to be a, this is going to be a redplane.png. And I'll put that file up to download. And so I'll load the image file. And we'll say convert alpha so that it is converted to our proper pixel format and maintains transparency. Now we need a rect for positioning. So self.rect equals self.image.getrect, our absolute favorite method. And we'll set the x to the x coordinate. We'll set the y to the y coordinate that we passed it. And we'll say self.player is that player plane. All right, looks good. I'll just store it as self.player though. Okay, and here's the update method that will make this plane behave a little bit different. I'm going to take self.rect.x, we're going to minus it by enemy speed times 1.5. So this is going to move quite a bit faster. Now you may want to change this value to make it even faster than 1.5, but we'll just start with that. And from here, we'll just go with the same kind of stuff, you know. If it's if the right-hand side of the plane is less than or equal to 0, then we need to reset it to the other side of the screen. Like so. And we will set the y value to some random value. So I'll use random.randint. And again, I'll use 50 and the width of the screen, or the height of the screen, I should say. Minus 50. So that just keeps it off the edges. And we will increase the points. But I realize there's a bug in my points mechanism because I'm going to keep giving points even though they're dead. We need to make, even if you crash, let's make sure that the plane is alive before we give them points. I think that makes more sense. So I'm gonna go ahead and take that little caveat and put that right here. We don't want to be giving ourselves points after we've already fallen to our demise. That would not be correct. Okay, so now that we've written our class, it's time to use it. Let's go over to our flying ace and let's think of a time that we could add more planes. So let's go to our update in our game loop here. So here's my game loop, and tell you what, right here, let's just say if self.plane.points is equal to 5, well then I want to add fast planes. Okay? So let's write that method. All right, so fast planes. Let's see here. I want the planes to kind of fly in off the side. And I don't want them to come in right when the other planes just reset position. So I'm going to set this x value to be at the width. Let's just say like plus 400 to give ourselves some time. And then once again, and do we have random imported in this module? I think so. We don't. We need to import random. So I'll import random as well in the flying ace module. And I'll take random.randint, and again we'll do that 50 to format dot height minus 50. Remember, I'm in the same module that I have my format class for my formats. So I just have to directly say format to get there. All right. So random dot randint, and that'll be my a random integer for my y values. And let's make a faster plane. I'll call it faster one is equal to enemy dot. Is it faster or fast? What do we call that? Let's go there and check it. It's, yeah, faster. Faster enemy. And we need an X and a Y and the self.plane. Is it plane or? Yeah, plane in this class, not player. And I'll say faster 2 equals enemy dot faster enemy X times 2. No. Let's do X plus another 400. Just to, well, no, because I want a different X and I want a different Y. So let's just go ahead and we're gonna make a whole nother one. So X equals format dot width. I'll say plus 800. So it's another 400 away. And we'll change the Y to the same thing, but a different random number. And now we'll make this one. All right, so next we need to do is we need to add these planes to our sprite group. So we have self.enemy group.add, and we need faster one and faster two. And, of course, if we want to draw it to the screen and update it, we need to have it to our all sprites group, which was just called sprites. Faster one, faster two. Okay, so if everything goes to plan, this should work now that we should get some of these faster planes once we have achieved 5 points. All right, so pretty simple start here. Of course, we'll add more stuff that we can do. Okay. Oh. Couldn't open redplane.png. Okay, well, now that I've got it in the right folder, it seems to work just fine, but we have an issue. So the issue we have is that as soon as one of them gets made, it's making tons of them. So what's happening is as soon as I have exactly 5 points, we're calling this self.addFastPlanes, and it's calling it over and over and over again. So it ends up filling the screen with these planes. So we need to make sure that we haven't done that yet. So we need to say... Well, there's lots of different things we do. We can make this a simple flag that makes sure that there are no planes that have been added, no fast planes that have been added. We could also just check simply the number of planes that are in our enemy group. So that's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to say and len self.enemy group is equal to 2. Since we start with 2 planes to start with, that's going to make sure that I don't call this again, because when we add to our enemy group after the first call, we won't have 2 planes anymore. All right. So just a couple more points here, and then we'll see how this works out. Okay. Oop, there's the fast plane. There's another one. And as you can see, they're coming pretty quick. And things are going to get more challenging because of it. So I think that's pretty good. And I got 10 points. All right. But it's still a little too easy. But we will work on that. And I will see you in the next video.